Welcome back to Klebs Tech and my continuing series on Fooocus for Stable Diffusion. In this video, I'm going to be covering checkpoint models and LoRAs. I'll explain where to get them, where to put the files. I'll also cover the basic usage of them and also the best way to tweak them and find the best settings for them. Why don't we just start right in? I'm going to assume that you already know how to install and you have everything set up for Fooocus. If not, I do have other videos that cover that and the basic usage. So the first thing I want to cover is where we actually save these files once you download them. We're going to start, this is your initial Fooocus folder, wherever you have it on your system. You're going to have the run.bat files. You'll have the Fooocus folder in there. That's the Fooocus program. So we're going to go into that. In there, you'll find a models folder. You'll go into the models folder. The two folders that you want to know about in here, and there are other things in these folders, because especially Fooocus will download things as it's needed. When you run each of those BAT files, it will download any models that are needed. When you go to do impainting or anything else, it'll download the models that are needed for those. But you can also download your own models for using within Fooocus. So we're going to cover the checkpoints and LoRAs in this one. So your checkpoints, think of those as your main brain. That's your primary model. That is where Fooocus is getting most of its information from. Think of LoRAs. Those are additive models. They will basically tweak the primary model. And sometimes you won't get the results that you always want, and you'll get different results while using a LoRA, because that's the point of it. So checkpoints, we will put in here. As you can see, I already have several. So this is where you would put your checkpoint files. You want preferably safe tensor files. As you can see, the file extensions, those are the safer files. Now, these are all very large files, so do keep that in mind. You're not gonna, unless you have a large hard drive, you're not gonna be putting a whole bunch of these in there. You can put them in other folders inside of these folders. That's not an issue when you go into Fooocus and choose them. You'll have those options still in there. So that's not an issue. So this is the folder where you'd save any checkpoints that you download. Now for LoRAs, those will be put in this folder. And that's really all there is to where you put the file. Just download it, put it into those locations. Once it's in those locations, Fooocus will be able to find it from there. If you download these while Fooocus is already running, you don't need to restart Fooocus. You can actually just on the model tab, you can go down to refresh all files. You can click on that and it'll actually refresh all the files, and then you should see them in the dropdowns. So now that we know where to put the files, I'm going to show you where to get those files. Many different places of where you can get them. There's a couple that I recommend, and there's actually one that I prefer. CivitAI.com. I'll include the link in the description. This is the one I prefer. This is the best one. Now, you do also have Hugging Face is another one. The downfall with Hugging Face is it's not easy to find what you're looking for. It's not a really good system for looking for things, but they are there. So I'm going to be actually covering this site. Now, the biggest thing you want to do whenever you're looking on here to narrow things down, because they have a lot of different models for different versions, different everything. And you really don't want to see a lot of stuff that you can't use. So in the filters, the first thing I'll recommend, go into your model types. Now, if you're looking for checkpoints, just select checkpoints. But we can also look for LoRAs and checkpoints here. So I can set those two. The other thing is to want to look for SDXL 1.0. You can, in theory, use LoRAs from 1.5 in Fooocus, but that's, I haven't really experimented with it. My understanding is you need to have an SDXL checkpoint initially. You'd have to use a refiner that is 1.5, and then you could use the 1.5 models. But like I said, I'm not going to cover that. That's the primary setting. That way you're not going to see a lot of these other ones. Like I said, the checkpoints are your main brain. So if you want to change those, you can look for checkpoints. The LoRAs are additive. Those can be characters, styles, clothing. There's all sorts of stuff, things that can change how the images will come out. I won't cover all the different possibilities because in all honesty, I haven't even played with a lot of them. The first thing I'm going to cover is, as far as the checkpoints go, I'm going to use this as an example just because by default, the run.bat, the standard Fooocus, will launch with the Juggernaut XL version 6. And they do have, at least while I'm using this, they do have version 8 already. So if you wanted to run version 8, you could. Do keep in mind that it's not going to probably perform exactly the same as version 6. In theory, it should be better, but if you're using a similar prompts, you may not get the same expected results when going even just from two checkpoints that are the same name. So do keep that in mind. Once you're on the page for a checkpoint or a LoRa, up here at the top, you'll find is the download options. There's also a lot more details in here, so you do want to read over these before you go ahead and just use them. So in here, we're gonna, if you want to, once you want to know what you want to download, you click on download options, you'll get the file that you can download, you'll click on that, and then you'll save it to those locations that we wanted to save it to. I actually already have this downloading in the background because for some reason it's taking forever at the moment. So while I wait for that to download, I'm showing you all this. So you'd want to go ahead and save it in your checkpoint folder. And now for LoRAs, it's the same idea, and I'll cover that more once we get to the LoRA step. As far as the checkpoint goes, I just went ahead and downloaded that, and then I'll show you how to change that inside of Fooocus. Okay, so we've downloaded our new checkpoint model, and I have Fooocus running. Now, I already had it running when I downloaded it, so as I explained, all you need to do is hit the refresh files when you're ready, because as you'll see in here, I don't have version 8 at the moment, so I'm going to go ahead, I'll hit refresh all files, and now it should show in here. And as you can see, we have the Juggernaut XL version 8, so I can just select that, and now whenever I hit generate, it's going to go ahead and use that model. Now, if you refresh this page or when you reload Fooocus, it will use the standard model that it defaults to, so you will have to go in and change that. Now, I do want to also mention, I didn't cover this before, there is the refiner, and I did mention about using Stable Diffusion model 1.5 for a refiner. You can do that, but you would put those files, those checkpoints in the same folder. So you could choose, we could have a base model of this one here, and then if we wanted to, we could have another one as a refiner. Now, I wouldn't do this. This is just to show you an example. And then the refiner switches. This tells it when it switches. If you have it way down here, it's going to do the first couple steps maybe with the first one, and then it'll switch over to the refiner, which if you're using a 1.5 to use a 1.5 LoRA, you'd probably want to do it that route from my understanding. Otherwise, you normally would want to have the base model and then the refiner just do the last little bit. I rarely ever use the refiner myself. I find in most cases I don't need to do that. That gives you an idea of how the checkpoints work. So as I said, you drop them in there, you just choose them, and then you go ahead and generate, and that's all there is to the checkpoints. Okay, now to move on to LoRAs. And before I move off of this one, I am going to show you this. When you first run, like the Run BAT, the photorealistic, it also does preload a LoRA into each of those. So for like the Run BAT, this has the SDXL offset example LoRA. My understanding is that LoRA is designed to improve image contrast for SDXL 1.0 models. Whether you use it or not, I don't see a major difference. Fooocus, they preset it because they feel that that gets better image quality. Now, I'm running on version 8 of this Juggernaut here, so I'm going to just hit none because I just don't want to apply that. Now, I'm also going to change the weight on that just as the default. Now, the weight is like I've talked about with in my other videos, if you watched any of them. Weight determines how much effect that has on your generation. The lower the weight, the less that gets priority. The higher the weight, the more it gets priority. Think of it as like a volume. So if you turn it way up, that volume is much louder. If you turn it down, it's much lower. For my purpose here, I'm going to go ahead, download this style. I haven't used it before. I'm making sure it's the SDXL because apparently they do offer it for both 1.5 and SDXL. You will notice down here, it does say it's for SDXL 1.0. You do want to look for that when you are getting LoRAs, unless you're doing what I talked about with the refiner, but I won't get into that. Now, some LoRAs do have trigger words. If that's the case, that means you have to use that word in order for the LoRa to be enabled or used. Some LoRAs do not. Some just automatically apply it for certain styles, certain effects. So it really depends. You want to look in here to find out if there's any trigger words that you need to use to make that work. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that. I'm going to download this. These files are always much smaller. It's one of the benefits of a LoRa. And I'm going to save that in my folder for LoRAs. Now I'm going to go to Fooocus. And now it's not in there, but if I hit refresh, it will now show in there. But before I do that, I do want to do a sample. So we're going to generate an image here of a cat just to get started. Okay, so we have that cat. Now, one thing I'm going to suggest is whenever you're testing the effects that these have on things, it's always best to use the same seed. So if I were to regenerate this using the same seed, I should get the same result because I haven't changed anything else. So when I do that, I go down to here to uncheck random, and it's going to actually show this is the last seed that was used. So I'm going to leave that as that. Now I'll go into my models. I'm going to enable this LoRA here. I'm going to leave it as a weight for one because for what I'm using it for, that's probably what I want. But that's the sort of thing you're going to want to try different results, and we'll experiment with that in here. Now in here, the only thing I'm going to change is I'm going to add that trigger word. Because like I said, for this LoRA, you need to use a trigger word. Other ones, you don't necessarily have to. That's something you'll have to look at the LoRA to find out. So let's go ahead and see what happens when I apply this. Okay, so we have our cat generated, and as you can see, it definitely applied the effect for that LoRA. Okay, so one thing I want to show you is I actually have my own LoRA that's trained on my goat. So I'm going to enable that, and there's a reason I'm showing this, and that's because I want to show the weight. This one's actually pretty well overtrained. I didn't really know what I was doing. I was using an online service at the time. But this will give you a pretty good example of how adjusting the weight will affect the resulting image. So just for reference, this is my actual goat. The pigs are AI all generated, but this is actually a picture of him. So let's go ahead and actually, now we're going to use, I'm going to do three pictures at different weights. They'll all be using the same seed. And I'm going to go ahead and generate this just with a Tigo, which is the keyword, a goat on a boat. Okay, so that's the first picture. Now let's go down and reduce the weight to 50% just to see what the difference is on this. Because as you can see, this actually did a pretty good job. You know, the patches here match up with these patches, the coloring, everything is pretty much consistent. So let's go ahead. I put this on 0.5 now. That's a 50% weight. So as we can see there, we have a little bit different result from the first image. This is the first image, and this was the second one. So as you can see, it still has some, like his patterns and things, those are still coming through, but now all of a sudden he's got horns. And the coloring is slightly different. So that gives you an idea of how the weight can affect things. And I'm going to do just one more at a real low weight just to give you a really good idea. So this is at 0.15. Now, in all honesty, it probably won't even be recognizable as him at all. Okay, so as we can see in this image, it really doesn't look like him at all. So that gives you an idea of how the weight can impact the results that you get from a LoRA. It's basically a volume knob if you think about it. If you turn it way down, it has little impact. If you turn it way up, it has, you know, great impact. Always experiment when it comes to the LoRAs to determine what you're going to be getting for results. Like I said, the best thing to do when you're experimenting is to turn off the random and use a set seed so you're constantly getting similar images and you can actually see what effects those have on what you're doing. Now, one thing I will also mention is that you can combine LoRAs with input images and things like that. So these can actually all be used with different checkpoints, different LoRAs. Those can be mixed. You know, most of these things can all be mixed and matched. just always test things out. Like I said, when you're experimenting, before you start producing a lot of images, turn off random, use a set seed, see how it affects it, and that'll give you a pretty good idea of where you need to adjust that LoRA and leave that LoRA when you're generating with it. Hopefully you found this video useful, and if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Also consider leaving a like since it does help the video. If you want to buy me a coffee, you can also leave a super thanks as well, and is greatly appreciated. In an upcoming video I'm working on, I'll cover inpainting, which is what I use to add the dancing pigs to this image of my goat. Thanks for watching. See you next time.